Hello students, today we are going to determine the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution using Colloredo's law. So the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution cannot be determined simply measuring the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at very very low concentration, because the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at very high dilution is very high. Therefore, with the help of Colloredo's law, we can determine the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution. So, if we determine the equivalent conductance of sodium acetate at infinite dilution, then hydrochloric acid at infinite dilution, and sodium chloride at infinite dilution, then we can determine the equivalent conductance of acetic acid at infinite dilution. So for this experiment, we have prepared 0.1 molar sodium acetate, 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid, and 0.1 molar sodium chloride solution. Now, from these Stokes solutions, we have to prepare 0.05 sodium acetate. So for this, we have prepared 0.05 sodium acetate from 0.1 sodium acetate solution by dilution formula. So we have prepared 0.05 molar sodium acetate, and from this we have to prepare 0.02 molar sodium acetate. Then we have to prepare 0.01 normal molar sodium acetate. Then we have to prepare 0.005 molar sodium acetate. We have prepared all the solutions. Now we will take the conductivity value for each and every solution. So this is the conductivity cell. Now we are taking the conductivity of the first solution. 0.001 sodium acetate. So it is already calibrated. So we have recorded the conductivity value. Next, we are recording the conductivity of the 0.005 sodium acetate. So we have seen that the conductivity is slightly increasing. The unit is millisiemen. And then again, we are measuring the conductivity of the next solution. So as you can see, it increases slightly. So we have recorded the value. Then again, we are measuring the conductivity of the next solution. So as you can see, the conductivity value is increasing with increasing concentration of the solution. So we have to record the value. So in this way, we have to record the conductivity value for all the solutions. So after measuring the conductance of every solution, we have to tabulate the conductance value against the concentration of all the electrolytes, and we have to plot the equivalent conductance versus the concentration of the electrolyte. Then we will get a linear plot, and if we extrapolate the plot, then we will get the conductance at infinite dilution.